Imagine if a simple eye scan could help protect millions of people against deadly infectious diseases. In Central Africa, a new smart technology is being used for the first time to help stop the spread of the Ebola virus. In 2019, the Democratic Republic of the Congo experienced the second largest Ebola outbreak in history. Diseases such as Ebola can easily cross porous borders. To stop the disease reaching neighbouring Rwanda, health professionals have been giving 200,000 people a new Ebola vaccine. But the challenge is determining who has been immunised with two doses of the vaccine. Healthcare workers are doing so using a small handheld scanning device that contains a camera and is connected to the internet. A health professional takes a picture of a person's iris, which has a unique pattern. They also note personal details, creating a secure digital immunisation record. The technology reduces physical contact and the risks of contracting the virus. The system sends an SMS text message to remind people to receive a second Ebola vaccine dose. That means the technology could be especially effective within low-income countries across Africa and beyond, where mobile phone use is common.
This has been a technology which is helping us now to be able to track those who have been vaccinated.
The innovation could also transform other immunisation campaigns. Rwanda already plans to use iris scanning technology to record which babies have received a measles rubella vaccine. Millions of people around the world live in conflict zones, fragile settings, or in countries that don't yet have effective record-keeping systems. Complete medical records for these people often don't exist, meaning they miss out on vital vaccines. Around 19 million children each year don't receive the childhood vaccinations they need. Eye scans could track who requires vaccines and text reminders sent to ensure people receive their required doses. This will help drive up immunisation coverage around the world. Innovations like this will help us save more lives. Let's get behind the future of vaccines.